finally, we got a good Chucky episode. Let's talk about it.
Say hi to the little woman for me.
All right, so you guys know for the past 2 weeks now, I've been saying that the episodes don't feel as good as the last series, and I told you guys why. It's missing that horror element, and it's missing a lot of Chucky. But this episode, Don Mancini put so much Chucky in it, I loved it. So that being said, let's go into the first point I got here. So the very first thing that I noticed here was they tried torturing Chucky in the beginning, but it didn't work. After they captured him, Jake, I think it was, put the knife in his finger and Chucky started laughing. How you find that funny is beyond me, but I think he was just pretending to act like it didn't work. And that's one of the things that I noted right here, is Chucky's in the episode more, and I absolutely loved it.
Hello, Gotham. Chucky's back in town.
From start to finish, Chucky's in about pretty much every scene, except for like two scenes with Lexi and then with the other girl, I don't remember her name, with the glasses, the redhead. Chucky's in pretty much every other scene though. And again, this is what I said we needed. This is what makes it feel more like a Chucky show, because it's called Chucky, but he was barely in the first two episodes. But anyways, let's keep going. So then they come up with this strange idea. I don't know if I've ever heard of this before, where they make you watch or do something to the point you get sick of it. So they had Chucky sit down and watch all these gory scenes from horror films. And at first he was laughing, he was like, oh, pass me a popcorn. And then after a while he kept watching, and then they put like drops in his eye. I'm not sure what the drops do. And they had his eyes open wide and he had to just look at it all night, and he ended up throwing up over and over and over. And I realized something, which is very true about that scene. You do something too much, you will get sick of it. Like, there was days back when I was probably in like high school, and I would play my game. Sometimes I'll play a game from like pretty much all day, and I would get so sick of it to the point where I actually felt like nauseous. So I thought that was pretty relatable, but I didn't know you could do that with movies and what. Like, I didn't know that was a real thing. But let's go on to the next point. And then did you guys catch the little reference that Chucky said when he was sitting down there being tortured? He's like,
Aunt Maggie, Chucky wants to watch the 9 o'clock news.
I thought that was really good. I thought that was really cool. I thought that was really funny. They end up torturing Chucky so much to the point that he's completely reprogrammed. Not even like he's like a stitch of his old self. He's like a whole new person. He's like this angel, like this sweet little Chucky. And I'm not gonna lie, I thought he was just BSing. I thought he was trolling them. But no, he was really reprogrammed. He was nice, he was sweet. They thought that he was acting cute sometimes. I don't know about that. I mean, I just couldn't look past all the things that he did, so I could never see him more than that. But they reprogrammed him. And the main reason they did this is Jake said that he needs to find a way to forgive Chucky. I'm gonna be honest, I don't know if I could do that, man. The way that dude killed his father, and I know Jake and his father had some rough times, but he killed his father, he killed the cat, he killed his cousin, he killed his uncle. Oh man, dude, he killed his freaking his uncle's wife. Like, dude, I couldn't forgive him, man. It's not even that I couldn't forgive him. I'd be able to forgive him, but I couldn't forget. And I could never look at him the same. That's my one rule about life. You forgive, but you never forget, bro. Never forget. If there's one thing you guys take from me, any type of advice you take from me, it's easy to forgive, it's hard to forget. But anyways, let's go on to the next point. The next thing that was important was the father saw Jake and Devin kiss on the steps. Now this one caught me by surprise, because when they kissed on the steps, I didn't think they would kiss in the church. Because, you know, there's so many people watching at all times. I thought that was a little bit risky, considering the fact that they don't want anybody to know about them. But they did it, and then the father saw them, and the father immediately starts punishing Devin. He starts punishing Devin by having Devin clean and just, what was it? He was cleaning in the chapel, I think it was. And he was cleaning all the I forgot what you call those things, man. It's not an urn. Oh my god, it's what you put the frankincense in, man. I can't remember it right now. No, it's not an urn. You guys know what it is. He had him start cleaning all those, And Devin was in there from like morning till like midday, just cleaning. And he was doing that as a way to punish Jake and Devin. Then Lexi has to be the one to babysit Chucky. So during the episode, they all cycle between who babysits Chucky. So then once Lexi's turn comes up, she can't do it because the way that the doll talks about Junior throws her off. And it throws her off because she still loves Junior. Even though she was a complete jerk to him, she still loves him and she misses him. But this new reprogrammed Chucky, I don't think he's even aware of what he did back then, which kind of gives a plot hole. And this kind of threw me off because when he said, Aunt Maggie, Chucky wants to watch 9 o'clock news, I was like, how does he know that? Because all the other Chuckies, when they first saw Andy, they didn't even recognize him. But how does he know to say that? You know what I'm saying? Oh my God. Then the next scene, bro. Chucky was hitting the gym, getting that protein in. Cause this dude came in that room, man, and he caught Lexi's bully, her old bully. This man punched a hole right through his chest on some Friday the 13th Jason stuff. I've only ever seen Jason do that, and we all know Jason is stupid strong. This dude Chucky punched a hole right through the dude's chest, grabbed his heart, and pulled it. I was like, what? I was like, I didn't know the doll was that strong. So then at the end of the episode, they show you which doll did it. It's some buffed ass doll, some big muscular doll. I'm like, what the heck? Chucky been hitting that gym, bro. He been going hard in that gym. And the way that the episode ends is the brolic new Chucky that got mailed to the church. Again, they keep opening these dolls when they should know the backstory. He ends up meeting the reprogrammed Chucky and he comes up in there cracking his knuckles. I'm like, oh damn, he gonna beat this Chucky's ass, boy. Either he's gonna do that, or they're gonna walk in on it and they're gonna see two dolls or something. I don't know what's gonna happen there, but man, I feel bad for that reprogrammed Chucky, man, because he's about to get his cheeks clapped, bro. Clapped. But this episode, other than that, it was fantastic. I like this episode a lot. I would give this episode, you guys might be surprised when I say, I'd give this episode like a 9. Yeah, do I wanna give it a 10? I don't know. I'm very stingy with my 10s. So I'm going to give this episode a 10. Yes, and here's why. There was another scene in this episode that was really good. Was when Lexi started to break down. Again, you guys know what I like. They show these human stories because that's what really is compelling, is the human side of these characters. Lexi was breaking down in the bathroom. She couldn't deal with it anymore, and she needed a friend to be by her side. And that's when the new girl comes in. I can't remember her name right now. It's not clicking with me. But that is what brings it to a 10 for me. The suspense. There wasn't a lot of horror, but there was a lot of suspense, and there was good storytelling, and they're going in a direction with the Chucky dolls possibly clashing that I do like. So I hope that this is a sign of things to come. I hope the next episode is good. Now, I was anticipating this because from the little scene that Sci-Fi released, I was like, bro, this doesn't look bad. Like, this looks pretty good. So I hope that they keep this up. Please, Don Mancini, keep this up. Those are my thoughts on it, guys. That's all I got.